This tree did not comfort her. It was as scared as she was. With nobody around to extinguish them, fires burned out of control.
Some words will stay with you, others are fleeting.
A strange blaze crackled ahead.
Is that fire? I've never seen a flame like that before.
The sacred bell lay silent on the ground.
Nearly there. Oh no. No, no, no. Where are the other fireflies? Please be here. Please be here.
Soon, the dreadful realization dawned on Robin. The fireflies were gone. A new determination rose in her. She would find. Knowledge.
Elder Ava! Something took the fireflies.
I know. Our people will fall sick without them.
There has to be a reason why this happened. I'll find out. I'll be back with answers. I promise.
Go, and may the love of this village guide you. Always.
Robin took a deep breath. She knew what she had to do. She would find answers, one way or another. The earth could fall away beneath her, but she would not be stopped. This was further than she'd ever been before. And yet it was exhilarating, wondrous, and terrifying. Fear was at her side, and hope in her heart. But things were about to get worse. Much, much worse.
Is that a dragon?
It's big. But Robin would not slow down. Not for crumbling paths. Not for giant monsters. She would get the fireflies back, no matter what. She would catch the dragon.
No, wait!
She raced forward. And leapt. Hello, Journal. We went to see Gran today, in the hospital. It looked like a big grey fortress. It took us a while to find the right room. Dad let me open the door. Gran has a big, cozy bed at home. Nothing like the hospital one she was in. Lying in there, she looked so small. I don't remember her being that small. Gran's eyes were open, but she struggled to